Generic greetings and welcome to Prison Architect once again. This time it's something a bit different and very, very special. Now, I've been doing Prison Architect on the channel for over 2 years and have produced over 325 videos, just to put it into perspective for you. Over the course of that, we have together made prisons. I've, you know, planned it and then built it all the way through several episodes and taking your comments and feedback and input to actually improve them and sometimes not improve them. But, you know, it's been an interesting journey. And the thing is, when I look back at it, I thought, well, wow, that's a lot of content on the channel. I mean, I've produced over 1,000 videos, so Prison Architect certainly isn't the majority. You know, I still think it's a variety channel, and the whole point of the channel was to feature interesting, different, you know, games that maybe people know about or don't know, and just games that I like and enjoy and that I think you might too. That's the overall idea of the channel, and I still think we're going for that. But, you know, there is still a fairly big bulk of Prison Architect content in there. I think it equates to about between a quarter and a third of all the videos produced, so it's certainly a big part of it. And up until recently, I used to make all of these, prisons and then share the save files, but because not a lot of people were actually taking them, and people were abusing it, and I decided to stop. But I thought when I was going back through the other day, I looked at all the prisons we made and I thought, wow, it's about time I actually released all of the save files. So that's what this video is about. Basically, if you go in the description of this video, there is a link to every single prison that I've made on the channel, as far as I can tell. It might not be an exhaustive list, it might not be every single one, because honestly, my backing up system is, well, it's non-existent, and it's scattershot, and the saves are all different. Remember, it's had 2 and a bit years or more of evolution, so, you know, I've lost things, things have changed, you know, life goes on and all that. I'm, you know, at the time I went, I don't need that, and just deleted it, or whatever. So it's all of the save files I can gather together. I think it's about right, but there might be one or two missing, but I thought it would be a good thing just to release it. So if you're just here for the save files, then in the description, all of the save files from Alpha 5, I believe, which is when we first started featuring Prison Architect on the channel, all the way up into our latest ones. There are some definite gaps in there, because I did skip some alphas, so some of them you might think, oh, we haven't got like an alpha between 30 and 30 odd, but or whatever. But there's some of them are on purpose, but there might be a couple that are just genuinely missing, which I can only apologize for. But I also thought it would be interesting to go back through and check them out, because most of them I haven't seen for years. That's the truth of the matter. I make these videos and read the comments and do that sort of thing, but I don't go back and watch the old videos. I mean, I know other people do. That's basically what you are doing. If you're watching this, then you are watching my videos, but I don't watch the old ones. I pretty much don't watch any of them, because, well, it's really difficult for me to do. Anyway, I thought it would be a good idea to go through them all and, you know, reminisce, wax nostalgic, whatever, and just see if they, I can remember anything about them. Yeah, I thought it would be a good idea and an interesting thing to do. But I have to warn you now, some of the saves just might not work. Now, obviously, most of the prisons we're going to see will be broken, right? They won't function as a prison because things have changed since then. There'll be a lot of changes to be made to even make them a functioning prison. But, you know, it's still going to be interesting to go through, and I thought people want them anyway. So here we go. Let's just jump straight in, press escape, and we will go to Lord Prison. And we can see all of the prisons that I've managed to cobble together. So these are the prisons from Alpha 5 and 6, because obviously we did skip over them, all the way up to the latest one, Alpha 34. So there's a lot of prisons here, and we can actually see the actual time when they were saved. So if we look at this one here, our very first prison is Alpha 5 to 6, which is, I believe, it was Mordor 2, Mordor's, which is the Featherstone prison. I can remember something about that. That was 29th of May 2013. So let's just load that one up, and that was when it was last modified. Let's load that one up and we'll see what we can glean from it. So we'll just wait for it all load up, and there we are. So we'll pause it for a second and we'll just take it in. Wow. This is Mordor 2 Mordor's, I think, and it is one of the first prisons I made on here as a construction series. It actually probably still works-ish. I don't know what that building is. That building currently doesn't have anything associated with it, which is weird. I don't know where the power is. Oh, the power is down there, so it does function. That might have been a workshop. I might have designated that as a workshop. As I said, I haven't gone through the old videos, so I'm just sort of guessing at this one. There's a little bookshelf in there for no reason. There's security up there. I'm guessing these are flashing because I haven't yet inactive build more CCTV monitors. I bet I haven't connected them up. I'm not going to go through all logistics and fix them. I'm just going to show them. There's some like power switches and pipe valves. Remember pipe valves when they actually were going to be a thing and no really bothered with them. There's the infirmary and morgue. I don't know what I was planning here because the morgue's huge, but you know, it's all in there. We've got security. We've got these cells. There's a fairly big cell, which I believe was Featherstone's one. In fact, should we find Featherstone? It would be rude not to, wouldn't it? Let's actually just go into our staff here, prisoners rather, and we will look for Featherstone. We'll start at the top and we'll work our way along. And have I missed them? Is this, have I just missed them? Go back through it again. Graskin, drummer. Garski? I'm trying to see if I remember any of the names, but I'm not seeing any of it. You know what? I don't know if Featherstone's in here, or whether I can't... Whether I just can't see it might be the thing, but as far as I can tell, there's no Featherstone in here. No Featherstone in here. Maybe there's a reason for that. It might not be the right prison. I might be remembering this wrong, but also, I'm pretty sure he left. Pretty sure that was the case. That he might have left. Either way, there's our first prison. It probably still works with a couple of tweaks. There's the workshop up there, actually. Yeah, so that definitely needs more stuff. And as you can see, it requires workshop saws and presses because currently we don't have any. I like the fact that we've done this. This is interesting. Power switches and pipe valves at the top of every single cell so we can always turn the water off. And that's still a good idea. That's still a very, very good idea and good thing to do. But honestly, it's not really needed anymore. It's part of the, you know, part of the prison doesn't really, when we first started playing this, you know, there was a threat of flooding and the idea that there was going to be pipes that you need to turn off and power and such, and having individual cell blocks turned off with a breaker box would be a very good idea. But because the game doesn't really do anything with it and hasn't done since this, then there's no real point in it. Wow, anyway, there's a common room in the middle there and phone booths and a yard. Yeah, I bet with a couple of tweaks this still works. Oh well, that's an interesting one. Let's move on. So we'll just go to, again, to load, and then we're going to go to, oh dear, oh dear. We're going to go to our alpha 7 to 9 prisons, which were minimum sec and maximum sec. So we're going to go for min sec first, and both of these did burn down. So I'm just, you know, point that out now. So let's just have a look at this. Wow, this is an interesting one. Look at that. That is interesting. For some reason, the shower, we haven't completed the shower in the middle. We've got laundry there, so laundry must have been introduced around about this alpha. Now, we've got, over this side, we've got, what's that, solitary in the corner, and then we've got a cleaning cupboard, security there. Then we've got fairly big cells, and with TVs in each one. Now, this is weird, because when I introduced the TVs back in this series, they didn't do anything for cell grading, because cell grading didn't exist. The quality of the cells didn't exist. But now, as you can see, that's cell quality 4, because it's got a television, and because of the size, and because of the window. So because of that, these are actually quite high quality cells, and it shows you either the foresight of IV and they wanted to do this in the first place, or that it's just pot luck and, you know, these things that have been introduced actually do still work out. So these are actually higher quality cells. It means that this prison is pretty much broken because you won't be able to do anything. Visitation in the center there is stupid, and them are large televisions. They don't even exist in the game anymore, but it looks like they still are in the game because, well, otherwise it wouldn't load up. I'm going to unpause it and I'm going to let the prisoners go around. Large TVs, remember them? Wow! That is an interesting one, isn't it? Because large televisions haven't existed in the game for a long time, but they must still be in the saves, in the files of the game. I mean, I know there's a lot of redundant stuff in the game, stuff that hasn't been used, but wow, yeah, large televisions. I wonder if they're going to be introduced. Who knows? Anyway, laundry's over there, we got solitary over there, we got a... Why is the infirmary so big? Why is the infirmary? Look at the size of it. There's no need for that. Got a workshop over there, which looks like it actually functions as well. Interesting. Showers there. You know what? Again, I think this prison could probably work. Kitchen might be a little bit small. No, kitchen's fine. This'll probably work. As a thing. Yeah. Not bad. Anyway, that's our lo- Oh, and it looks like we were going to do something up the top there before it broke. I don't know what happened with this one, but it did break. I think it was something to do with the laundry. The laundry was really, really bugged at the time, and it just didn't work. Wow, interesting. Anyway, let's just continue on. I'm going to try and speed this up, because if I keep doing 2 or 3 minutes on each prison, we're going to be here for hours, which I don't think anyone cares about that. We could probably do that, but still. Right, okay, this is our high-risk prison, and it did not go. It didn't go so well. In fact, as you can see, we've got firemen over here, right? There we go, firemen. They're actually walking out. We did have a bit of a fire. I can't remember exactly what happened, but it was something to do with water, obviously, because there was some electrocution. Oh, that's right. People started punching these drains, okay? And then what happened is the drains were punch, and then that let the water from the shower heads through and then touched the metal detector, which then made a fire and then obviously burnt all of this down. And as you can see, we got 25 dead bodies. And I think I said it at the time like that as well. Wow. But we did have this really weird center section where you used to come in either side. You could come in four sides and then, you know, you'd go to this canteen, which I still... It probably still works, and the kitchen's over there. That was really problematic because the workmen had to come along. Remember, there wasn't automatic door openers at this time, so that was problematic. Visitation in the centre is a stupid idea. Again, my infirmary and morgue are far too big, but, you know, that's just how it works. And if we go over here, we can see we've got security, shower, common room, and common room there. The common room's actually quite good there. I do like the way we've opened them up, and obviously these cells are fairly chunky. And we've got this wall that goes all the way around. This is probably a medium-sized prison. And we've obviously got all of the workshop on that there. And we would have used perimeter wall if it existed at the time, but obviously it doesn't. You can see we had plans for four cells, but it did burn down. And I think it was at both sides as well. Yeah, that's not good. And we had security. It's weird because this is different for this one. And obviously we've got a yard in the center there with solitary rat on the outside. Yeah, that's right. We had them as, I think we called them coolers at the time as well. Put them on the outside so they can sweat it off. Anyway, there's that one, and there's a laundry in the middle as well with a big security room. Obviously, if we were doing this again, we would probably put in the door openers and stuff in there, and we'd have an armory and such, because this is a high risk. The first time we ever did high risk. Interesting, right? Let's continue on. Load save, and we'll go for... That was alpha 7 to 9, so I guess it will be alpha 10 onwards, will it? Let me just check up the top. Yep, it'll be about alpha 10, so... I haven't been saying the times here. So, alpha 5 to 6 was the 29th of May, then the other is the 29th of May, then this is 28th of June. So, I assume that those were... maybe I've loaded that game and then saved it from then, because obviously we didn't do all of these in the same time. So, this would have actually wouldn't have been May. It'll have been like March or something. But yeah, anyway, 28th of June, 2013, alpha 10. So, let's have a look at alpha 10 prison, and what is this one about? Well, it looks like we've got, I think I've started doing symmetrical prisons by this point, and I actually really like the look of it. That's an interesting look, isn't it? We've got solitary down the side here, which is an interesting choice. I don't know why I've put it on this side, and visitation's in their storage there, a couple of dead rooms, and then we've got the power station and the capacitors outside, which you can do, you know, there's no reason why you can't, there's no rain or anything to break it, but I don't know why we've got the two of them. I think this is the workshop update, or there was at least an update for the workshops a couple of alphas ago, and I decided to make a prison that was basically about making some cash, and we'd have two workshops, which is why, if we go to our utilities, we can probably see from electrical cable, yeah, most of the prison, or part of the prison is powered by light green, the other by dark green, so we actually have all of these working, and obviously we've got the laundry, and we've got enough here, so we can probably have, how many staff? Let's just go for... logistics and prison labor. We can have 15 in each, so we can have sort of 30 prisoners working in there. But this was at a time when you didn't have to train the prisoners, okay? You didn't have to teach them to work in there. There was no workshop safety induction, so they would just work in there. They would come in and work. So yeah, that's an interesting one. I don't know why that cell's there. We've got a cleaning cupboard there, shower at the bottom, security there as well. It's a bit of a weird size. We've also got a little common room with basically phone booths there. I do like the way that these are self-contained. We've done self-contained ones before, but that's an interesting look. And the capacity is 60 as well, so it's quite good. I really like the look of that. That's my favourite so far. That's quite good. And obviously in the middle we've got a kitchen and the... And this one here, the, I can't remember the name of it, canteen. And, like, little walkways. We haven't got any metal detectors. I reckon this will have a lot of contraband problems, especially with the walkway all the way on the outside. This will have a lot of contraband problems, but it's very green. Ah, not bad at all. Let's load the next one. So we'll load, and that was alpha 10, so we'll go for 11. So we're basically going up now. 25th of July, 2013... Oh, Pod Prison, my favourite prison pretty much of all time, I think. It's the one I'm most proud of. Honestly, I think it's the most interesting we've made. It is the most different. It is a weird design. It functions well at the time. It is completely broken now, but at the time it was really interesting and different, and I still think it is one of the best, if not the best, prison I've made. Basically, for those who don't know, because I'm aware that, you know, you might not have been watching since the beginning, which was two and a half years ago or whatever. So the idea for Pod Prison was we have four individual pods connected by these center bits. The idea, I think originally was just to have connections, and then I realized that there was nowhere near enough space, so I had to have these center sections here. And this was at a time, remember, when laying foundations was a nightmare, and it would often break, and it wouldn't place, and having to do this, it was just horrible. And I remember planning this off. I actually used a Minecraft tool at the time, because I think I was playing Minecraft a lot on the channel as well, a little bit on the channel. But I did, I used a Minecraft tool that would work out circles, because obviously you can't make, you can't make circles in the game. So I used a Minecraft tool to work out whatever this size was. So it would be 35 by 35, and it would make a circle, and that's what plan these edges off, which is why it looks so good. Obviously, we've got laundry on the left, cleaning cupboard there. Now, the reason this is completely broken is because these cells, originally the cells did not have to be enclosed, which is why they're all open. There was a lot of comments at the time saying this is going to break and it wouldn't work. And actually, it did. It worked completely fine. There was no problems at all. But let's just go to reports and this thing here, valuation. And we can see there's been no deaths in it, as far as I can tell. So, not bad. Not bad at all. Infirmary down the bottom, another cleaning cupboard with a morgue there, and then obviously workshop. This was a really good idea. We had workshop all the way around on the outside, and then in the center we had a storage area. Now, this doesn't really work anymore because, as far as I can tell, the workshops, I could be wrong about this, but the workshops had to have, they have to have tables in them, and also all of the saws and presses to be a valid room now. Could be wrong about that, but in this center bit, as you can see, we're storing stuff there. And when I say valid room, I mean, if you don't have them, the prisoners won't work there. Actually, now that I think about it, I'm completely unsure. I think the prisoners might be able to work there, but it just shouts at you saying, you do need a table, you do need a table. The thing is, there's no optional, really. It should say, you should have, you know, if for most rooms, I think, when it says room requirements, it should say, these are required, these are recommended, these are optional. So this should say, you know, for example, room requirements for workshop would be, you know, recommended circular saws for, you know, trees or whatever, recommended circular saws and presses for license plates and tables, and then storage, you know, recommended table, suggested table or whatever. But either way, we made stuff on the outside and we stored it in the middle. But this was a time when you didn't have to take it to exports, which means it was just sold from there. This is completely broken. This is our CCTV monitor, and originally they were like a curved one, and you could do this where you put someone in the center and they would be watch all of the others. But they changed that because originally it was a case of if there was someone standing, it would basically, if they're in proximity, if they're in like a front tile, then they would activate that, but now it's not. They have to actually man the thing, so this wouldn't work at all. Over here, we've got storage far too big. We've got visitation. We could probably switch them around. This is where we have our office, which obviously doesn't need to be enclosed. Actually, it does need to be enclosed, but there's a minimum size 4x4. I thought that would be. But yeah, there's that. We got our capacitors and power blocks. Up the top here, we've got a holding cell with a shower and some solitary, which is a really, really weird size. And then obviously in the center, we've got our canteen as well. And I think we've got a couple of weird... There we go. Look, there's some people with different shirts on for some reason. There's Graham Tyson as your Graham Flared Tyson or whatever he is, facing game and all that. We've got another one over here on the left. I saw someone with another t-shirt in game. There's also fighting. You can hear fighting going on. I'm actually surprised that the prison loads. I'm very surprised that these are just loading. Anyway, Pod Prison. My favourite prison, I think. Still, it's my favourite prison. We'll load until I load another one and go, oh, man, that's my favourite prison. Ah, Alpha 11 Coliseum. This is the start of the Fight Club episodes. Originally, a lot of people said, oh, you should make it so you were fighting. And I've still maintained that the whole point of the construction series, well, it's, you know, it is what it is. It's named quite well. You know, it's Ron Seal. It does what it says on the tin. In this case, it's construction. We build things. Fight Club was introduced to basically allow us to, you know, I think it was this one. It was the first one we made, the Colosseum. It was just to bring people in, 300, and we have a fight in the center. That's all it was. And that, there you go. There you go. For anyone that's all the violent people, you know, the COD Twitch players, you know, something hasn't been shot in 45 seconds. Rocking back and forward, you know, sort of ADHD style. You know, that's yeah, that's why this was introduced, you know. ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. I think it's that. Anyway, either way, or ADD or whatever it is, basically. I don't know why I care about that. Either way, for all those people who really have got violent tendencies, that's why we did a Fight Club. And then once I made this, I thought, well, it seems a bit rude and also a bit of a strange choice to make a Colosseum and do that, and then but also be making all these prisons and then not burn them down at the end, you know, just as a separate thing. We've built them, then we can do the Fight Club, and then it gets both parties interested. So there you go. Anyway, Colosseum. It's not really something we made specifically for the construction series, but it's there nonetheless. Alpha 12, 29th of August, 2013, and... this was, I believe it was nicknamed Stalag Prison, or something like that. We did, I started to shy away from the whole, prisoner of war camp type prison. You know, I like the fact that you can make it, and I know there's even mods around there that allows you to do it. But I think we wanted to make these individual chalets that did turn out basically to be sort of very the Great Escape, prisoner of war type prison. But, you know, it is what it is, and I think it works quite well, this one. Today's beverage is milk. Good for bones. We don't actually have doors on these prisons, so it's fairly easy to fix. We could just put doors on them. It looks like it's all high risk as well, this prison, and it's nearly 100 capacity, which is quite cool. In the centre, we have the infirmary and cleaning cupboard. Oh, no, sorry, laundry and cleaning cupboard. Yard on the outside with, obviously, the weight benches. Common room there. Loads of televisions. We've got no phone booths, as far as I can tell. No, there's no... there is phone booths. There are phone booths separately in here. Then we've got our workshop as well. Again, most of these prisons, I don't know... I think that is too small. That canteen and kitchen is way too small. We'd have to expand the kitchen. But yeah, I guess it exists. I think a lot of these prisons, I don't know whether it's because the game has certainly changed over the course of the last couple of years, but you can argue that the scope has increased. You know, I mean, well, I don't know. I don't know what the right terms would be, but people talk about scope creep, as in they originally set out to do this, and then more features get added on. Now, right at the beginning, they've always said, well, we want to do this. This is the idea we want to do. So I don't know whether there's been scope creep because they've always set out to do that. They've always set out to do pretty much what they have done, like now what we've got now in the latest alphas. But the actual fundamentals of the game, like this now, you know, basically putting prisons in cells and make sure they are held well, that hasn't really changed, as you can see from these prisons. It's good. It's more of a historical document, this thing, isn't it? Right, interesting prison. Nothing really much to say about it, to be honest with you. It seems to work okay. A couple of changes will probably fix this thing. Right, moving on. Load. So that was Alpha... Is Alpha 12? Alpha 12. Yeah, so Alpha 13, 27th of September 2013. Load that one, and... Oh, I can't remember this one. I've got no memory of this prison at all. It looks like it's a completely mixed prison, and that's the first in game. Actually, that's a gang member, I think. The 42nd. Is that a gang member? That can't be right. We can't even check, I don't think. What do we check? Informants, yeah, that there. Dangers. Am I missing a tab here? Micromanagement. Don't know. Dangers. Informants. Don't know if we've got a gang member there. Bring some emergency stuff in. Prison labour. Room quality. Room quality, look at that. Interesting. Anyway, yeah, it's a mixed prison by the look of it, and we've got showers down the bottom, common rooms as well, basically on top and bottom. It is a symmetrical prison again. Workshop at the back there. It's a very interesting one because it's very open, as you can see, and this is the first prison, I think, we've got a perimeter wall all the way around. So this is when perimeter walls are introduced. It's got a fairly big yard. It's actually a fairly big prison, this one. This is a medium size, surely. Is this medium or is this small? I can't tell. Well, easy to tell if I do this. 80. No, it's a small prison. Interesting one. Don't know why I've put all of the staff and stuff at the back. And you can see that obviously they definitely have changed the CCTV monitors because they don't work like that anymore. But this one's a mixed prison. 104 capacity. 85 prisoners. Got a couple of solitaries as well. Not solitary, sorry. Where is solitary in this thing? Solitary's on the top and bottom there, yeah, on the back. Then we've got some holding cells there. Common room is nowhere near big enough, but yeah, it exists. Looks like it works. It's one of the least interesting ones, I think. Let's move on. Lords, that was Alpha 13. Alpha 14, 4th of December 2013. God, it's going to take forever, this video. You know what? That's fine. People, most people who wanted just to download the things have already downloaded it, so I might as well just keep taking my time on this one. Right. This one. Now, I think I do remember this one. This is where we did expand over. The idea was we built this bit, and then we expanded to add more stuff, and that's exactly what we did. So as you can see, we've got these wings on either side where we had offices there as well. We've also got the dog kennel, and I believe there was a dog kennel there. Yes, there is. As you can see, there's a staff door and stuff. I think there was a dog kennel there, but we had to get rid of it because having two of them broke the game. We've also got two massive workshops, which is good as well. Obviously, that wouldn't work now because of just, you know, the way the game functions. There's no way to, having two workshops like that, not a good idea because of the, you know, you'd need to train them all and stuff. It would probably work, but not as good. We've got the very small individual cells here, and not too bad at all. We've got a little shower there as well. I do like these little blocks like that. I'm going to have to make another prison. Maybe the next prison I make is going to have these little sort of chalets and separate enclosed ones, so you can see, oh yeah, it's cell block A or Z or whatever, or G. Go for the middle. There you go. And we've got you've got CCTV cameras in there as well. So how many we've got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12. 12 in total then. Not bad. 133 prisoners capacity. Common room there. We've got some cleaning cupboards. Double cleaning cupboards there. Triple. Oh, we've got quadruple cleaning cupboards. Just cleaning cupboard, cleaning cupboard, cleaning cupboard, cleaning cupboard. No point in that. You can just make it as big as you want now, and you can assign more people to it. So there's no point in that at all. Showers in the back, obviously. Security again, completely broken. And I think we can say that canteen is big enough. Yeah. Now this one works. As far as I can tell, that'll work, and it's quite big. Interesting, that one. Moving on. Lord Prison. That was 14. Yeah. 16th of December, this is Alpha 15, or 2013, we were loaded up, and wow, this is a weird one, isn't it? This is probably the prison that I decided, I'm sick of symmetry, we're going to move on. I go through different waves where I go, yeah, we're not going to do symmetry this this series, and this one is a high-risk prison, and it is fairly cramped. 74 prisoners, all cramped in this one cell block. Showers on either side. The first time I think we've done these little block bits where we have like a visitor table on either side, but we have like these walls that go around. That was actually courtesy of one of my friends as well. He used to, you know, used to play Prison Architect and quite a bit, and he did that, and I basically nicked the design. Haha. Cheers, John. Right, and we've got these workshops either side with storage in the middle again. That's probably wouldn't work now, but it's good to see. I really like doing that. I might try and make it work before, and I might try and make it work another time. Yeah. Oh, here we go. I do remember this bit. This quite fondly. We wanted to make a all-purpose room for, I guess it would be recreation, which is why we have like a, this is one big common room, and again, without knowing it, we could change things around now. We've got this big common room, which is to do with watching televisions, which they don't sit on the chairs and do it, but there's televisions there, phone booths, and pool tables, and we also have some little toilets as well. It might not be little toilets, it might be standard-sized toilets. We have a gym on the top right. As you can see, we've got basically weight benches in here. We've got a shower room, and then we've got a library. This was the library which basically didn't do anything. Libraries, well, didn't exist back then. Obviously, they do now. You can actually buy, you know, you can bring books in, and then you can, you know, rent books out. So libraries do exist. Also, classrooms exist. That's what this one would probably have been back then if they existed. Or anything, really. A classroom, a library. It could be anything, this thing. But, you know, at the moment, it was just basically a room where they went and sat. We've got a big yard there. Not bad at all with more stuff there. I don't know why we've got loads and loads of dog crates. Basically, if it's new in the alpha, we used to overdo it. You know, or best overdo doing it rather than underdoing. Staff room, we have well overdone that. Look at the size of that staff room. That is insane. We could have made that storage and changed it around. And the thing is, I'm not going to beat myself up over this one. Remember, when I first started playing, I was absolutely terrible. And, you know, over 2.5 years, I have probably got better by 2.3%, something like that. So I'm still absolutely horrendous at the game, but I think I'm better. I'm certainly better than when I first started playing, and I've got better sense of the scales and things like that. But either way, I'm not going to beat myself over it. It was, you know, it's a product of his. All of these prisons are a product of their time. But anyway, it seems to work. Interesting size, interesting look. Yeah, not bad at all. Move on, Lord Prison, Alpha 15 Festive. Now, this is 23rd of December 2013, and if we load that up, it is our Christmas prison. Oh, look at that. What a pile of garbage. We had a lot of problems making this thing. It actually looks better in night, so I'm going to speed up to max speed, because if it goes to night, it looks a lot better. In fact, how long is that going to take? It's probably going to take quite a while to get to night. We might not get there. Either way, this was the Christmas episode prison. So as you can see, we've got basically a Christmas tree for the design of it, which is a bit weird. We've got these boxes at the bottom, which we actually said is like presents under the tree, and we've got even like a little bit of wire railing is like a ribbon, because I thought that the closest thing to ribbons is obviously barbed wire. That's how we do it in our house, so there you go. Right, moving on, we can see we've got a kitchen, which is really tiny. We've got a canteen there. We got cells, and you know what? It's quite weird, because this is probably a prison that would work. The kennel doesn't, obviously. We need to change the kennel, but... Oh, yeah, we need to just put a couple of bits there. I think the reason we didn't do that, it was actually broke at the time, but we might be able to fix that now, because there was a lot of problems with pathfinding back in the day. Maybe putting that in will actually fix it, but yeah, it looks like they're coming along and fixing it. You can see there's actually been improvements in the pathfinding since then, which is good, so we might actually get this thing finished. Visitation is one room, we've got infirmary there, so we've got all of the things we really need to run this thing. Prison capacity is a little bit garbage, it's only 10, but you know, it works. It's an interesting one, isn't it? Well, obviously, we've got all these lights there. We've got a star on the top, and we've got little baubles on there. And in the dark, it does look quite good. There you go. Very, very small one, but it was a festive prison. It was a nice, interesting one. Good to look at, actually. Lord Prison. So, Alpha 16, 20th of January 2014. We're about halfway now. And, this was the first one to introduce a couple of things. Forestry and also lakes. So, they changed it so you can randomly generate lakes and forests and buildings, but also introduced forestry. Actually, no. This didn't have forestry. This had trees that you could plant. There is a difference. Forestry is a room. It is technically a room, which is there, okay? And you can designate something as forestry, and that sets up work for the gardeners, I believe. It might be the workmen. I think they did change, actually. I think it was one and changed to the other. But the idea was, you know, that would manually plant trees. But they change it so you can actually basically just use... You could cut down logs. You could get logs and you could sell the logs for more than the tree was worth. So that was a little bit of money. You could then saw them logs into planks, which could sell for more money. And now you can actually take them planks and make them into beds, which nobody does really. See, I certainly don't do that in the construction series, because it takes too long to train people up. And I think there still is an issue there. If you're playing the long game, maybe you might get there. At the moment, it's pretty much redundant, because by the time you've trained someone to work in the workshop and then they become interested in actually wanting to do the carpentry apprenticeship, it's sort of redundant, you know. I just don't think it works that well. But either way, you know, that's what you could do here. And we've got this nice lake on the outside, and obviously you can see all the trees and such. We've got some clipping things going on there. Over this left-hand side, we've got a... What's this? It looks like it's a... Not a solitary. That's solitary up there. This is a holding cell. Fairly big common room there. Laundry and solitary again. Oh, that's not solitary. It's just a toilet. And that's an interesting one. Look at that. This is our new sort of cell block. It's still self-contained, but it's a shower and then a really big row of cells, which is quite good. It's sort of an expansion of the one we saw a couple of loads ago when we had you know, the small individual blocks, you know, where they only hold 10 prisoners. This one is quite big. And obviously, we've got that one there. In fact, that's the only one. 116 prisoners can't be just in that one there. Oh, no, it's over this side. Yes, there we go. We did expand the prison over to this side. And as you can see, it's, we've got two kitchens, two canteens, which I don't think worked at the time very well. But yeah, as you can see, it's in. And, you know, it's common room on there and shower on the bottom. And yeah, it worked, I guess. And obviously, the idea for this prison was just to make loads and loads of cash. Wouldn't really work this. To be honest now, I don't think it would work at all, really, because of the way you need to get prisoners and put them in the workshop and actually train them up. Looks like this is a medium and high risk prison, so you know, it's an interesting one. First time forestry was introduced, and first time we've had a bit of water. Anyway, let's go to load game and we'll continue on. So that was Alpha 16. We'll go for Alpha 17, 26th of February 2014. We'll load that up, and ooh. That's a weird one. Again, same sort of design that I've been doing for a couple of the other cell blocks, top and bottom. It's just a common theme here. It's high risk by the look of it. All the way around, we've got a security fence. We've got a, what's it called? Perimeter wall. Very, very small yard. This was the idea that we had a prison that was pretty much solely indoors. This was a completely indoor prison. They would never see the light of day. Even the yard, I think there was only the yard. Only the yard, I believe, was outside. Let's have a quick check. We can go to our, I think, flooring. Say grass. Yes, we can place grass there. But that's the only place we can place grass. If we just click and drag. There you go. No, hang on. That's the wrong place. There. Yep, you can see that the only outside bit that the prisoners would ever experience would be that bit of yard. That bit of yard and that bit of yard. Yep, so this was the indoor prison. We staggered the cells so they would look top and bottom. So basically, the idea was that the prisoners would only look out onto a blank wall. They wouldn't be able to converse with their inmates and they wouldn't be able to pass things. Because obviously, it's not in the game, but the idea was that, you know, you couldn't get people to pass things from one to the other because they couldn't reach around and pass something there. So, yeah, that's actually quite a decent security feature, that one. I don't think this is the most interesting prison, but I think it's one of the, to look at, rather. It's not the most interesting to look at. It's very dark and grey and bland, and I'm sure at the time that's what I went to, was making it for. But I think it's one of the most interesting in terms of design. It's very smart design, even though a lot of the things we designed for aren't actually in the game and still aren't in the game. Either way, there you go. There's that prison. Loading on. So, yeah, this is definitely going to take some time. Alpha 17, 26th of February 2014, and that's one I've just loaded. Alpha 18, then. Alpha 18, 28th of March 2014. What is this one? I think this is the forestry prison. Yep, this is the first time we've used forestry. Forestry all the way at the back to then bring it in here and then saw it up to make them. To make stacks of wood. Make planks. Bear in mind, though, that you didn't have to train prisoners to work in the workshop again. Now, that would be, this would be quite problematic. It's an interesting one, I guess. I mean, we've got a common room there going all the way around. A very, very small common room. I think this was designed so you came out, you went in there, then you went in the common room, and then you went into work, and then you came back that way. I think there's a reason why it's designed like it is. It's all right, I guess. It's all right. I do like these individual cell blocks. I'm definitely going to be making these in my next prison because I not forgot about it, but we haven't really made one like that for a while, I don't think. Yards right in the center. Kitchens are there. Visitations blocked off either side. I like the way that we've got a center bit where the guests would come along here and then in here and then into visitation. There's no way that the prisoners could walk there. Actually, no, there we go. They would walk that way, wouldn't they? Yeah. So it works. It functions, right? And we've got a big holding cell. 92 prisoners as capacity. That's all right. Forestry, obviously, a bit glitchy. So when that tree would be removed, these walls would be removed at the time as well. And I still think that is the case. Oh, looks like we've also got an armory. First armory that I've noticed as well. So, yeah. I don't know why I put it there. But, you know, armory's up there as well. Cool. Not bad at all. Lord Prison. That was Alpha 18, was it? Yes. Alpha 19. By the way, if I've missed one of these out, I do apologise. As I said, it's hard for me to remember exactly which ones we've gone through and which ones we've skipped. Alpha 19. It is the 23rd of April 2014. Load that up. And ah, right. The city prison. Now, this I remember quite fondly because it was something that I wanted to do for quite some time. And you know, it was something that I was always hesitant to do because you are going beyond the bounds of what the game is supposed to be. And a lot of people have made prisons with individual rooms like this, for example. You can see we've got individual rooms here with you know, the shower heads and TVs. But at the time, it did nothing. People even made ones with their cookers and things like that in, which, again, didn't do anything, but they were there. Now, it's weird because the latest updates have actually made this a lot more feasible because these would be higher rating because they now have a television, they have a bigger size, and they have a shower, which means that should be, what, grading 4? Grading 3. It's because this shower bit. Ah, right, yeah. If I increase that, if I, like, did this, for example. Well, let's let it resize itself, there we are. Yeah, grading 4. So, all we needed to do is increase that size, and it's now grading 4. And there's a Featherstone. James Featherstone. I knew we'd find a Featherstone. There's been a Featherstone in many, many prisons. But yeah, this is our city prison anyway. So, but the cell grading works, as you can see. That's pretty good. So the city prison, the idea was we have this main stretch of road, like a highway on this side, and it goes right across a bridge. Then it comes in. Obviously, it is still a prison, so you have to sort of understand that. Comes into a very large storage, really pointless, fairly big yard over there, which is supposed to be like a basketball court or something. The power station was over this side. Fairly big yard, like, and then the duck pond here. And then we had a sort of weird forest area over this side where it's basically like an open forest, which is obviously forestry where people can work there. We had like an eatery here where we had like a canteen where people can go in. There's the toilets for the canteen. I wouldn't say canteen was like a, it was like a sort of an eatery, like a restaurant or something like that. So, you know, this they all eat, and then there's the toilets for the restaurant. This is a main stretch of road right down the center, as you can see, and obviously we made it so it goes up, and you could, I think there was a car park originally, and then we deleted it. This area, we've got psychologists and warden's office, and basically just areas where you can walk around, obviously staff room and things. This is like a sport hall and recreation area. There's our gym that then goes into what would be a locker room, which is why I've got filing cabinets there, and then a shower. So it was all about the role playing on this one, and these were supposed to be individual flats, as in they come in, you know, this would be room A, you know, this would be like, I don't know, like 32, this would be like block 32, and then be 32 A, B, C, D, so it would be standard sort of flat apartments, whatever you would call them, and obviously some of them were Lakeview apartments as well. In fact, this one had like a nice little sort of jetty on the outside, so you can fish, or just have a nice, you know, look at the moon when you're standing there at night. Oh, nice. And then we've got laundry and cleaning cupboard, and these ones were, this was the jail, right? So this was the cop shop. This was the cop shop. This was the police station. So we had security here with a front desk, and then you would be taken into the holding cell here, where you would, you know, well, I guess you would just be held there, obviously waiting area there. And then if you were bad, then obviously we had an armory there, and we would take you to the individual solitary, which did have beds in, and these would be the individual cells. You know, not bad at all. Kennel at the back as well. And then these visitation here, we class this as like a shop front. So these would be the shop fronts, which would basically just be visitation. And we actually had little windows in as well. Sadly, these ones have got large windows on, so it's a bit sort of Back to the Future 2 when everything's all messed up and you had to have bars on all the windows. Or if you just live in a really bad area. I was going to name a city, but I thought that was just going to put people right off. Immediately, Baltimore sprang into my head, because when I think of like sort of cities with bars on them and like, you know, a bit sort of rough, I always think Baltimore, because I've watched The Wire, not because I've been to Baltimore, and I haven't seen Baltimore, I haven't been there or anything like that, so, you know, it's not really a diss, but I watched The Wire recently again, so, you know, Baltimore immediately came in my head. Bodymore Murderland, as it's called in there. Let's load on, and what are we going to get next time? We're going to Alpha. Sorry, what was that one? That was Alpha 19, was it, I believe? Yeah, that was Alpha 19. Lord, so we're going to Alpha 20, which is actually the same thing. It just expanded, if I remember rightly. Yep, this is a definite expansion, and the game is running like a bag of hammers. Let's just pause that, and we'll have a look. So, I'm not going to go back through what this bit was, because obviously I've just explained that. We did change a couple of things. This area here was a, this is now obviously a classroom. So you can see the evolution of the game from our, you know, from the previous first couple of saves up to this one. So we now got classroom. This hasn't changed. This has, so we've got an infirmary now. This is a junkyard. Now, the reason this exists is because I tried to build something and it didn't work. So I had a massive problem with that, and it just didn't work. So I basically made it a junkyard just to try and fix it, because I had some, I tried to build a bit of foundation and it didn't work, and I had to delete it, and then it, not all of it deleted, and I could probably do it now, but originally we put it as a junkyard right near this, actually, do we use it as garbage? Yeah, I think we might have used it as garbage, actually. We have this as garbage. So it is still a junkyard, but it is also a working room. Up the top is all the same. I'm just going to run down the bottom here. This is actually nothing. This doesn't actually do anything, but I think we were originally going to use it as forestry. But because it was so close to the wall, we couldn't block it off. So, yeah, that's just like a nice little outcropping. But I like the fact that we've got like a lake coming in here, and it goes right up here. This is a big car park, which then goes into the mall. Okay, which is a big common room, as you can see. This was supposed to be a mall, and each individual shop would sell different things. So this was a common room that was like, this sold televisions. Yeah, it's like in a, you know, home appliance, whatever. This sold televisions, and there's the little desk at the front there, the storefront. This is a bed, you know, this is where you go direct beds, or, you know, your beds for you. And also, oh, this was the carpet warehouse, wasn't it? Because we've got different individual carpets and tiles at the back here. Look at that. Good grief, I'm actually surprised in how much I can actually remember. I'm sure for everything I've remembered, probably, for every two things I remembered, half of it is wrong, and I've probably, you know, I only remembered one out of 10 things, but I'm still surprised at how much stuff I can, you know, recall. Yeah, this is the bed store and carpet. This is the pool table store, whatever that was. This was like a sofa store and, like a, I think it was Staples, I think I call it, but it was like a home office and home, it was like a home furnishings and appliance, and not home furnishings and office store. So we had obviously tables and chairs, like a DFS discount sofas, filing cabinets, office desks, school desks, all of that sort of thing. This one is a DIY store. So obviously we sold carpenters' tables and workshop saws. This is obviously a bookstore because we've got loads of bookshelves in there. This is a, I guess it would be a kitchen sort of outlet and white goods, I think it would be called in America. Sort of cookers and sinks and laundry machines, fridges, freezers, ironing boards. And then this one is mobile phone store. Yeah, mobile phone store because we use phone booths. Yeah, fantastic. That's pretty cool. Moving up here, we've got the mansion. We did want a mansion, right? We did want a mansion. And actually, we'll leave that for now because we have to come down this road here. We had basically like a sort of Miami style gym and like gym on the beach. Looking over here, we got an office which is basically I think that was supposed to be like a tourist information or something like that. A fairly big lump of trees here because that was supposed to be trees stopping people, stopping the peasants, you know, looking into the mansion. The mansion, it has actually got a purpose. We've got a staff room in the center, and we've got the. We've got the accountants, we've got a bit of security, and we've got the warden's office as well. We've got, on this side, we've got a power station, which powers a lot of things, and also, we've got like a sprinkler system here as well. We've also got a power station powering all this one. I bet if I go to utilities here, the game's going to lag out like a boss, but also we've got four power stations. This one, more power stations than we've ever had in any of the other prisons. Then we move up and we've got sort of, you would class it as sort of medium residential sort of type areas where we've got in the center a nice sort of park, and it always gives me fisheye that. I don't know why that looks, it gives a sort of fisheye effect. It's a bit weird. But this is where we got some electric chairs, and that's the statue we went for. We went for an electric chair statue thing. Excuse me, you need a sip of beverage there. And we've got individual cells. So, again, these don't work. You know, actually, though, they probably will work if you expand them. But they were supposed to be separate houses. So we've got a double bed. You know, we got basically two bedrooms, a little sort of storage area. A little sort of, it's like front room type office thing, whatever you want to call it in there, and then come out. Honestly, they did work and most of this stuff wasn't used. If you wanted to, you could easily put a couple more doors and walls in here and have two cells that would be of higher quality. So, you know, put a couple, I mean, this thing here with a shower and a bed, and all you need to do is put like a television or a radio there and one window, and that would be cell 4 or 5 quality. So you're fine. Individual yards as well, where we could come out here and use that. I believe these are sectioned off by deployment. Some of them are. Some of them aren't. Maybe it's because of the load, who knows. But either way, these are sectioned off. Up here, we have the, I guess it would be the towers, the blocks, the blocks from Dread, I think I call them from Dread, because Dread's an awesome film, and, you know, they're basically very, very cramped conditions. But, sort of strangely, these were some of the best cells you could, well, not the best cells, but they're quite good cells. Obviously, over here, we've got these quite cramped up and stuff, and we've got them separate with a television in. These ones are not the smallest you could get because we've got shower heads in them as well. So these are individual as well. So these would be higher quality. And if you put a window on there, they'd be cell quality 4. Maybe even 5 because of the size. Who knows? But either way, 100 and... I don't know. It's still generating, actually. I'll unpause it and I'll watch it generate how many cells... Oh, what the capacity is. Actually, it's lagging out like a boss. I'm going to leave it. Probably high capacity. Probably close to 200 capacity, this thing. The entire map. But yeah, we got, you know, two big blocks, like tower blocks either side, and then the center we got a canteen and stuff, and it was like a fast food thing, I think. Wow, yeah, prison. This was like a city prison, wasn't it? Or town prison, whatever you want to call it. I can't remember where I originally got the idea from. I know Flabaliki was originally going to do something like this as well, and I don't know if he ever did, but yeah, I think, I don't know where the idea came from that. I don't know whether I stole it from him or whatever, or whether I went, yeah, that's a good idea, I might try that. But I know he mentioned it. I know several people have mentioned doing a one like this before, which is, I think there was certain comments as well saying you should do like a city type thing. Don't know whether other people have done it as well, but either way, one of the most interesting ones, certainly one of the most different. Right, we'll load it on, and that was Alpha 21, I believe, or 20. We'll go for 21, which is 17th of June, and this is weird. It's not symmetrical. It's got a big P there, and I don't know why. I think it was just the size of it. We've got some individual cells here, which are quite large. Again, if you class these as grading now, these would be quite good. I've used ceramic tiles on the floor, which makes them look quite good. But we've got individual showers, and obviously that could be quite high quality. Not very interesting, this prison at all, actually. Nothing really much to say about it. What's all that? Solitary at the back there. Fairly large in size in terms of we give prisoners a lot of space, but it's more about keeping the prisoners in here. We've also got some classroom in there as well, and that looks like it could have been the first Alcoholics Anonymous. At least that I've noticed. Anyway, Alpha 21. Not that interesting, but you know, it exists. Lord, we'll go for 22, which is... No, 22 we skipped by the look of it, or it doesn't... Or I've lost it. I think I skipped it. Alpha 23, 26th of August, 2014. So we're almost... No, we're over halfway now, I guess. This is... I don't know what this one was about. Obviously, we've expanded it to have a high-capacity prison. Yard in the middle, workshop there. I don't think there's anything to say about that one. It exists, and there's nothing really of note that I can see. I don't know whether I went for a high-capacity prison or not. I think this might have been the capacity prison where we just tried to make a very, very high capacity. But yeah, we did expand. As you can see, we expanded on this side as well. There you go. Nothing much to say about that one. We might be going through the lull. Alpha 24, 22nd of September 2014. We might be going through the dry zone where we're doing not a lot. Ah, now this... that's something that I haven't mentioned. I've just remembered something. This is the Imperial Architect mod prison, where we made basically the Death Star, as you can see, with TIE fighters there, and also that's like a Lambda class shuttle, but it's obviously not to scale. But we made a Death Star, which is basically a big orb, and some people were calling it a Pokeball, which is, you know, no. It's Star Wars, obviously. You know, with the big circle there for the eye where it blasts stuff out, and we actually put we put the electric chair in the center to give it a bit of detail, where, you know, that's where the death beam would come out, you know, quite ironically, because it'd been a electric chair which causes death. Yeah, Star Wars prison didn't hold many people, was really inefficient, but it did work and it was interesting. But this has reminded me of something. This doesn't require the Imperial Architect mod, but if you use the Imperial Architect mod, it looks a lot better. Now, there's a prison previously. Actually, is it previous? We might not have come to it yet, but I know there was a prison previously that used a mod, and it might have been the like asylum mod, or it was like a health mod. It was certainly a mod that you had to use in order for it to look different, where you would get different things, and it made it look it was like a hospital mod or something like that. That was the previous one. I can't remember what it was called now. It was like in asylum or a hospital or something to do with health, something like that. But either way, that was the previous mod. This one also requires a mod. I don't know if I mentioned that right at the start, but I did mention that some of these might not work. Let's go to Lord, and that was... I can't remember what it was. That was... I think it was Alpha 23, wasn't it? Let me just quickly load it. No, so that was 24, which means we've got to go to 25. I know you might be thinking, oh, I can't remember which one he's loaded, but I've just gone through all of these, and I'm trying to do this in real time and remembering all of other stuff. Right, so 25 is really bloody weird. What is this all about? It's high risk. No, it's not. It's medium and high. Separate cells in these weird cell blocks with walkways all the way around on the outside. You can see that the rooms now, you can see there is a theme, and that's that the rooms are getting smaller. I don't know what this one was all about. But looks like we have... Is there a mix of prisoners? Yeah, there's a bit of a mix of prisoners, actually. Ah. Oh! Protective Custody and Supermax. Was this the first prison we had for Supermax prisoners? Because there's Alex... Ace Studios Osler, which is our first legendary prisoner, I believe, in the game. Oh, okay, yeah, everything I remember that, yeah. Legendary prisoner. Right, okay, interesting. It was a mixed prison, but we had different way to assign the prisoners, so you could change their category. So supermax, all that sort of thing. And that was our first legendary prisoner. Okay. So the prison itself, design-wise, is not that interesting. But, you know, the actual people that are in it are. Not bad. Love prison. Alpha 26. 25th of November 2014. Surely it's going to be another Christmas one. I have no idea what this is. I assume I haven't finished it. It's certainly not finished, and I don't know whether that's because I've lost the other saves or whether I didn't get it finished at the time. Either way, it is huge. I think it's the first... This might be the first large map I used. Big walkway... I think the reason why we've got this gap all the way around the outside is because it might be the first time a contraband could be flung in. I think that's why we've done that. These are very, very large and open, but I don't know why that is. I must confess, I don't even remember this prison at all. Might sound strange, but I don't remember this prison. And I don't know whether we ever got it finished or not. Either way, this is the only save I have for it. So, yeah, there you go. That's that. Loading on. So, that is 20... Yeah, that was 25. No, that was 26, wasn't it? Did I load 25? Of course, I loaded 25. Yeah, sorry. Load. 26, 27. 15th of December, 2014... Ah, right. I know what it is. It's a rollover. It's why it's named differently in the save files. It's the same prison, this one, but I've rolled it over to the next one. So we did finish it. We have got it finished. And, this was the sectioning off prison. This was the highest risk I'd ever attempted at the time. I did it so the center was going to be high risk. And then the outside here, either side, was going to be super max. But we sort of messed it up. I messed it up. You know, many will share in our success, but I bear solely and very heavily the blame of failure when it comes to these things. These ones on the outside were super max. But obviously, most of them that were assigned to these super max areas don't really require to be super max. So, to be honest with you, you can just change the designations, right? The only reason there were supermax is basically we needed somewhere to put them. But we have quite high capacity. And yeah, obviously the reason why the saves were rolled over is because, we moved from one alpha to the other. But yeah, we did finish it off, which is good because I don't like to leave unfinished projects. But this prison did not work very well as far as I can remember. It functioned, but the original idea, the premise, didn't go well. You know, like I needed to expand this center one up to about maybe here and have a couple of cell blocks, maybe 10 down the bottom for our legendary prisoners. Oh well, it exists and it works and it's quite high capacity and it's big. Loading on. 27, 28, 27th of January of this year. Ah, the making money prison, I think this was. We wanted to make some cash. And we've got carpentry in there. Maybe this is the first time carpentry is introduced. Bit of forestry, workshop on the top and bottom, and enough people to work in here. It's all low risk. I think because of the previous prison, I remember New Batty, I don't know why. Because of the previous prison, I wanted to do something that was not high risk, and that's why we've got low risk and we wanted them to work in the workshop. Yeah. Nothing much to say about that, apart from it works, and I don't know why, but I've got these massive cell blocks in the middle. Don't know why. Normally I put them right at the top like that, but I just decided for whatever reason put them in the middle. And it seems to work because there's a nice walkway down the center. Yeah, that could probably make some money. Again, a couple of tweaks, you probably get it going there. Lord, 6th of February this year, Alpha 29. Ah, forestry. No, it's an expanded version of the one we've just had, but it's just got forestry in a yard on this side. I'm not even going to comment on that one. It's pretty much self-explanatory. Alpha 30. March of this year. Yep, want to do a central prison? That's just weird, isn't it? That is weird. Got yards on the other side. We've got the two sets of canteens, which don't really work properly, but, you know, I guess it does sort of function in some way. First time we've had a library, as far as I can remember. We got the first library in the game. Workshop up the top there doesn't really do anything. Kennel down the bottom with our staff, with our, chief and other sort of people in there, psychologists as well, infirmary. Medium prison seems to work. Again, not that interesting to look and talk about, but I guess it's library was the first one we've introduced. Lord game. Alpha 31, 21st of April of this year, and, yeah, I remember this, I was thinking, what's all this over here? I couldn't remember this bit, and then I looked at this side. Very first time we've done execution. Very first time we had death row. That's what this prison is. It's death row prison. The very first one. And it's, yeah. It's weird to remember because it was, I remember actually pulling the, you know, pulling the lever the first time on this and thinking, wow, they've done this really well. They've done this very, very well. And it's something you have to give them a lot of respect for because it would have been very easy to just have it as a button and walk them in and then they die. You know, you could have had prisons doing that, but I like the way that they've made it a lot more. It's got a lot more gravitas the way they've done it, where they've had it so you bring prisoners in and you have to manually press all the button, and it's actually a proper event rather than just another order you give to guards. So yeah, death row prison. All of our high risks over here. Death row on the left. We haven't done that in a while, and we probably should do death row for the next one. And then we've got sort of visitation down the bottom, and, you know, it's not symmetrical, it was never meant to be, and this all this area was sectioned off. Obviously, you can only get through to the death row of area from this area there. Parole is at this side. I think I need to redesign that one. Parole, because it wasn't really parole, that one. That is more getting off, I don't know what it's called, clemency, like a load of clemency and stuff. If you might be let off from death row and put into a supermax at high risk. But yeah, first death row prison, wow. So that was April, was it? Yeah. May. 25th of May, Alpha 32. This is, I guess it was, yeah, this is also death row. We also have death row on the left here, with execution there as well, which we have used. And it's very high capacity. Ah, this is the first time that the smaller cells were introduced. Or at least the time we did it. Because as you can see, the cells are 2x2. So, toilet and bed, and that's it. And a little gap to go in between. And very high capacity, 125 by the look of it. Not bad. Runs, seems to run quite well. And then we did expand it over to the right-hand side. And we had a workshop and a big lump of forestry, which we never did because we ran out of time to actually do it. But, you know, it still exists. And we've got a kennel and we've got an armory and things like that. But this was, is it mixed? Yeah, it's mixed. High risk and normal risk. Oh, no, I guess normal risk, and some of these high risk will be because they've killed someone or I've manually changed the associations. So yeah, not really a great design, not like an interesting design in any way, but it is interesting to see that we've got these smaller cells. Alpha 33, 29th of June. There we go. One we've pretty much just went through. And this is an expanding prison as well. We did this bit, which is just basically quite standard. But I think it is the first time that we had library over here, parole, classroom, and this is the first prison grading. First time we had prison grading. So, you know, there you go. We've got people reading books, and we've got the bookshelf in there, and cells with different grading. Center, obviously, was slightly quite different. And as we expand to the left, you can see it all gets all different. It basically gets higher grading, and as you can see, these cells here are really, really high quality. And finally, the latest one that we've just went through, Alpha 34. There you are. You know, it was, I don't know what their idea for this one was, but sand's awesome, which we've been talking about recently. But yeah, it was the idea to make a prison that wasn't symmetrical. I think that's where the idea came from. Coming in there and up, and then, you know, many different things that they could do. Workshop was there. I don't know what the overall, I can't remember what the overall theme was. Obviously, high risk is what we've gone for here, and I think it was the shop. Yeah, the shop was the new introduction, and post as well. I haven't mentioned the post in the previous ones. There was post in the previous ones, but obviously we haven't really used it because it was broke then. I did remove it in some of the other ones, but there was post as well. And obviously we've got our shop in the latest one, and gangs. This obviously was gang prison, so that's why we did high risk. So yeah, whew. That was, I don't know how long this video is, but I'm not going to apologise for it. I'm glad I've went through and shown all the prisons, at least all the ones I can think of. I will apologise if I've missed any of the prisons that were on that list and I haven't shown all the saves of missing. You know, I've done my best, but yeah. Interesting. It is 2.5 years of going, basically going back through the prisons. Feels like 2.5 years going through it, but no, it's been a little bit of time to go back through all of the prisons that have been produced on the channel over the last 2.5 years. And honestly, if you wanted to see the prisons I've built in single player, then the file is probably 2 or 3 times the size of all in ones there. So yeah, puts it in perspective. I've played a lot of Prison Architect. I think we all knew that, really, didn't we? I think me and you knew that. Anyway, there we go. If anyone's still actually here, well, obviously you're listening now, but you're probably the only one. Either way, there is all of the saves I can manage to get from the backups and from the online storage where I host it, and just all over the place, and all of the several different hard drives I've got and stuff. All of Prison I managed to scrape up. Links in the description so you can not only check the game out yourself, but also download all of these saves. If you download them, then I really hope you enjoy them and play with them, and feel free to fix them and change them and do whatever you want with them. Also, feel free to share them with anyone you want, put them anywhere, you know, upload them, do whatever you want. The only thing that I require, and, you know, well, request really, is that if you do upload them, then please give original credit to myself and give a link to my YouTube channel. That's the only thing I want. Even if you upload it with all of your changes, you know, basically credit me as the original creator and give a link to my YouTube channel. That's all that I request. I don't think that's unreasonable. Either way, I hope you've enjoyed this trip down memory lane. It's been an interesting one for me, that's for sure. Thank you, as always, for watching. Comments in the comments. Take care, and generic partings.